Assalamualaikum. Hi, my name is Shami bin Hanif and this is my final year project proposal presentation. My supervisor is Associate Professor Engineer Dr. Amir Razi Abdul Ghani, while my co-supervisor is Associate Professor Technologist Dr. Ramzi Zan Ramli. So my title is Engine Mapping of Formula SIE Car Engine. Let's go to it. Topics that we will discuss is project summary, objectives, background, literature review, project problem statement, coverage, methodology, and lastly the expected result. Actually, this project is carried out under the UiT Motorsport Club in preparation for the next Formula SIE competition. In this project, I will set up and optimize the new Formula SIE car engine management system to achieve the best performance fuel efficiency while ensure the engine sustainability. On the right side, you can see the previous Formula SIE car from UiTM Shah Alam that is in Australia Formula SIE competition in 2016. Let's see the objective. We have three objectives, which is to determine critical engine mapping parameter on engine performance. Second is to determine the best value of engine mapping parameter, while the third one is to optimize the engine performance in terms of horsepower, torque and fuel efficiency. For the background, engine mapping is a process of modeling vehicle's engine behavior by controlling the engine's adjustable parameters. As we know, modern cars has many input sensors that will affect the engine's behavior, such as acceleration and top speed. And engine mapping is widely used in Formula 1, Formula SIE, diesel engine, commercial car, and also modern motorcycle. It is important because by remapping the ECU or engine mapping, you are able to optimize your vehicle for the application you want. Second is more precise amount of fuel injected into the engine will improve the fuel economy. And the last one, it control amount of exhaust gas emissions such as hydrocarbon, nitrogen oxide and carbon monoxide. For the literature review, engine mapping process includes data logging for fuel injector opening time, which will contribute to the maximum engine power, said Miljik and et al. Second is significant engine mapping parameter, which is combustion period, ignition timing, air fuel ratio, valve timing, exhaust gas recirculation, valve position, and the lastly is variable length of the intake runners. Third one is ignition timing value for highest torque and horsepower. A source said that 17 crank angle to 35 crank angle will give the highest torque and horsepower, but the source said that spark advance that give highest torque is different among other engine because it depends on AFR, engine speed, engine load, fuel properties, engine temperature, air temperature and humidity. The fourth one is air fuel ratio value for highest torque and horsepower. Two source said that 12.6 of AFR will give the highest performance. Last one is engine mapping for fuel efficiency. AFR of 16 and AFR of 14.5 will give the best fuel efficiency. And for the spark advance or ignition timing, more spark advance will give lower brake specific fuel consumption. That means the better fuel economy. For the problem statement, currently the engine is not fully set up due to the COVID-19 last 2 years. And the engine need to be tuned to its maximum potential. At the right side, the current situation of the engine in the workshop. The project scope is it focuses on manipulating the engine management system or engine mapping. An experiment model analysis will be done using a hub dynamometer. For the limitation, it only involves the engine management system but not other physical components such as piston size and valve size. Okay, there is many components involved, which is Kawasaki ER6F engine, Power Commander 5 ignition module, Power Commander 5 fuel ignition module, Dynampad 3000 hub dynamometer and Power Commander 5 software that will be used to control the parameter. So methodology has two that I will be explaining. The first one is final year project methodology and the second one is stage 5 engine performance experiment basic cycle. So the first one is final year project methodology. In this project, I divide into 7 stages. The first stage is problem identification and objectives. The second stage is literature review, where I collect the information required in this project. The stage 3 is determining required parameter, which is the engine parameter. Stage 4 is engine setup, service, diagnosis with Power Commander 5 installation. The engine need to be serviced because it left for 2 years. Stage 5 is engine performance experiment, which I will be explaining in the next slide. Stage 6, the data recording and documentation. And the lastly is finalize the engine fine tuning configuration as the preparation for the next race. Next is the stage 5 engine performance experiment basic cycle. In the experiment, there are three main cycles or three main processes. The first one is engine mapping or changing the engine parameter, such as ignition timing and FU ratio. After change the parameter, we test the engine on the hub dyno to see the result. After that, we analyze at the third process, we analyze the engine result to see the horsepower and torque graph. After that, we repeat the process until we achieve the best value of the parameter. So what is expected from this project? We have four expected results. The first one is critical engine mapping parameters, the best ignition timing value, the third is the best FU ratio value, the fourth is expected engine performance result. For the critical engine mapping parameters, we expect for two parameters. The first one is ignition timing, the second is FU ratio. Both parameter will be controlled using the Power Commander 5 tuning device and software. But for the ignition timing, it can be controlled by advancing or retarding the crankshaft angle value relative to the piston top dead center or TDC. While for FU ratio, it can be controlled by setting the AFR in the reach AFR below 14.7 for gasoline engine or lean condition AFR above 14.7. And this AFR will be observed using a external or auxiliary AFR wideband meter. So for the second one is the best ignition timing value. What is the value? From engine speed of idle until 9000 RPM, which is the maximum, we target that 10 degree CA or crank angle to 35 crank angle will be the best ignition timing. And this we expect that it will give the highest maximum torque and horsepower. At the bottom, the best ignition timing is not exactly the same with other engine. This means that we need to test it ourselves on the dyno to get the best value. This is because as stated below before, it is depends on many factors. At the right side, you can see the figure where you can show the piston position relative to the spark ignition timing. So the third expected result is the FU ratio value. From idle to maximum, which is 9000 RPM, the value of FU ratio will be decreasing. This is because lean AFR in the low RPM to make it save fuel, decrease fuel consumption. Below the graph, the higher the RPM, we set the AFR in reach condition, which is 14.7 and above, to allow better combustion and cool the combustion chamber to maintain the engine temperature. At the right side, you can see the software engine mapping in the FU ratio fuel map. We can see I already set the value of AFR for each RPM value. So the last one is expected engine performance result. The maximum torque will be decreased 2 Nm from the standard spec, while horsepower will be decreased by 2 also horsepower, and the fuel efficiency will increase by 1 km/L. For torque and horsepower, it decreases because the use of air restrictor by the Formula SIE organizer. It restricted the air come into the engine. So hence, it will decrease slightly compared to the standard spec, but it is still high from the standard. Or we say that it will only slightly decrease the engine performance. I think that's all for me. If you have any question, you can email me or just call to the email and the phone number. I think that's all from me. Assalamualaikum.